Hello, people. Welcome to episode 56 of My Pickups. And I've got quite a few games here to show you. I've got ranging from PlayStation 2, Mega Drive, GameCube, NES. The NES has returned, yep. Game Gear. And a box of Game Boy stuff. So, yeah, pretty fucking cool. So let's get started. This is all off of eBay. No pickups out in the wild. It's been far too cold here. It's been snowing. I know a lot of my friends down in England. I've got a lot of snow down there as well, and I hope everybody's all right. And yeah, so I've got a lot of pickups off of eBay. These were all while I was off work. I'm back at work now. It's going well, should I say. Stressful going back to work after having so much time off, but you know, first week back and, second week back, and we're doing alright, so, cool. Anyway, let's get started. We'll start with Mega Drive, and I picked up a game that I wanted for a long time. Now, I've seen Mr. Neckbreaker's videos, he was uploading these, each level gameplay of this game, and I just decided to bite the bullet and go and buy a copy for myself, and that is, of course, Castle of Illusion. Starring Mickey Mouse, and I absolutely love this game. I can remember playing it when I was young, and that's it, boxed and complete. Now that's going to the blooper reel. That's the manual, but it's boxed and complete, and it's in really, really good condition. Actually, I'm really, really impressed with it. I'm going to hold the manual now. There we go. So I'm really happy with it. The box is nice as well. I'll show you the back of the box there. Little screenshots of the game. Karma just doesn't seem to want to focus anymore, so hopefully that's picked that up. But yeah, it's fine. So, Castle of Illusion, starring Mickey Mouse. I've been playing this quite a lot, actually, since I've got it, and haven't completed it yet. It's actually a little bit difficult towards the end of the game, but it's really, really cool. Only thing that's wrong with it doesn't have its hanging tab at the top, but I'm not bothered about that with Mega Drive games at all. Really, really happy to own that. This cost me £6 all in. It was £3 for the game and £3 postage, which is pretty good actually in this game, because it can go for a lot more, so I'm really, really pleased to have that in my collection. As a lot of you know already, I'm starting to downsize my collection quite a lot. So for Mega Drive, I'm picking up Disney games, platformers, fighting games, a couple of racing games, and the football sports games for the Mega Drive. We'll go with PlayStation 2 next, and this is a, I wouldn't say obscure kind of title. It's well known within the community. It's a horror, survival horror game, which is what I'm going for on the PS2. And I have this on the Xbox, and I have been playing it on the Xbox recently, and it's pretty good, so I decided I wanted the PS2 version of it, and that is Project Zero. Pretty fucking awesome game. Really well worth picking this up. It's really creepy. Not many games out there like survival horror games really grab my attention in terms of playing it and getting scared, but this game's definitely getting it. This game is definitely creepy as hell. Really enjoying it at the moment. Haven't plugged it in on the PS2 yet, but the disc hasn't got any scratches, so I know it'll work fine. But on the Xbox, it's pretty awesome. So I'm really, really happy with this. It's even got a little warning sticker on the back. For some people, using this game will require particular precautions during use. These are outlined in the attached notice. Don't know if you can see that. But yeah, there's no attached notice, so we'll see. But no, really happy to own that. This game cost me £11, and it was, I think it was £2.50 postage. It came well packed, so I was happy with that. It's in mint condition, so that's really, really cool. And a couple of you know that I found Project Zero 2 out in the wild a few months ago now. And yeah, so I just need to get Project Zero 3 now, which goes for quite a lot of money on eBay, but I will definitely be picking that up because I really like Project Zero. And I love my survival horror games as well. Right, moving on to, we'll do Game Gear, actually. Castle of Illusion again. I have the loose cart of this game. You'll have seen it in my Sega Game Gear collection video. But I really wanted to get a boxed copy of it. And this is in mint condition. The only thing that's wrong with this is it's got a little bit of a tear here. But aside from that, it's in mint. It looks brand new. And for 99p, I could not go wrong with that. So I'm over the moon. It's a fantastic game on the Mega Drive and on the Game Gear. When my Game Gear was working, I used to play this quite a bit. So yeah, absolutely love it. It's a fantastic game and well worth getting a Game Gear for, in all honesty. It's a fantastic game, that one. Also got another game, because it was 99p and it was in mint condition, The Chess Master. I don't know what to say about that, really. It's in mint condition, and it probably won't get much gameplay once I get a working Game Gear, but 99p. Off the same seller. I mean, the seller combined the postage. It was actually £3 postage for this item and for Castle of Illusion, like, each, but it just did £3 postage for the two of them, which I thought was really nice of him, actually, and it came well packed, so I'm really, really pleased with that. So yeah, The Chess Master. So that's my Game Gear pickups, boxed and complete games. If I can get them for 99p, I'm picking them up. You know, I might stretch to like £2-3, depending on what the game is, but that's pretty much my target for Game Gear, try and get as many Game Gear games for 99p as possible, boxed and complete. Seem to be doing alright with them at the moment as well. Right, moving on to GameCube, because I know there's a massive fan base for GameCube out there on this community. It seems to be one of the most popular consoles to collect for, and I'm well getting into collecting for it, I have to say. I've got three games here, two of them I'm really happy with and one I'm really not happy with at all, but I'll show you that one last. But the first one up is Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance. Now, I've been trying to get this on the PS2, but I keep getting outbid on it, so I just decided to put a cheeky bid on for the GameCube version, and I won it. I won this for £3, and it was £150 or £250 postage, I can't remember. But yeah, this is pretty decent. I haven't played it yet, but it definitely looks like my girlfriend's type of game. She loves games like this. She got all excited when she seen it. So yeah, scored some brownie points there. That is boxed and complete. Can't go wrong with that. That's pretty cool. You know, so I'm really pleased with that. I'm hoping to get Dark Alliance 2. I think Dark Alliance 2 is on the GameCube, so I'll probably opt to get that on the GameCube. If not, it'll be on PS2. But yeah, absolutely friggin' awesome. Next up, I'm really happy to get this one. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Boxed and complete in really nice condition. Not sure if it's normal to have English and Spanish in the back of the box. It's even got Spanish at the top of the game here. So I'm not sure if this was originally Spanish. In fact, I'm pretty sure it is, actually. So yeah, but it works fine on our GameCube. It plays in English, so that's cool. So I'm not bothered. But yeah, so that is boxed and complete, and that's pretty sweet. So really happy with that. That cost me £5.50, and it was £3 postage. So a little bit more pricey, but it's a really, really good game apparently. So I'm looking forward to checking that one out. And plus, it goes into the GameCube collection that my girlfriend's got. That seems to be growing by the minute. It's getting quite a lot of games in there now, so it's cool. Some of the GameCube games on eBay are popping up cheap, so I'm just picking them up, you know. Obviously the rarer ones are going for more money. And you'll have seen that in a previous video, I managed to get Wind Waker. So yeah, I'm trying to pick them up anyway. And this is another game I picked up now, I'm not happy with this one. The seller neglected to mention something about this game, and I'll show you it anyway. It's Sonic Heroes. Now, don't have this in the GameCube already. Have it on the PS2, I think it is. Or Xbox. No, Xbox. Have it on Xbox. But I am not happy with the game because of that. It's the wrong friggin' manual. And the manual, anyway, is all ripped to hell. It's the right game, thankfully. But the way the seller listed it, he said it was complete with manual. However, I'm going to show you how it came to me. When I opened the box, it was like that. So I decided, right, okay, I want to see the manual. So I took this out, and it was like that. He put it in the wrong way around. And now I'm thinking he did that deliberately, because he knew it wasn't the right manual. And maybe he was thinking that I wouldn't check it. So, I mean, for what I spent on it, it was £1.74 and it was £2 postage. So for £3.74, I can't really go wrong. I've still got the game. But, you know, I'm really pissed with that. And the seller really didn't help at all. sent him a message saying, look, there's a wrong manual in here, and the way you put it in looks like, you know, you did that deliberately. He says, nah, sorry, there's nothing I can do, you've got the game now. So, he wouldn't even accept a return on that, so, what are you going to do? Don't worry, I left him negative feedback, so. But anyway, moving on to NES. Now, I've got a PAL game and an NTSC game. American games. So I'll show you the American game first, and it's a game I've wanted for ages. It's a crap game. It really is terrible. It's made by LGN. We all know them for making rubbish games. But I just wanted it in the collection, and it's Friday the 13th. And it's boxed and complete, and it's in really nice condition. It's in really, really good condition there. Show you the top of the box and the bottom. I love Friday the 13th, the movie franchise. I absolutely love it. It's my favourite, actually, over Nightmare on Elm Street. I just think Jason's just far cooler and more badass. But, yeah, I really wanted to get the game. I seen Angry Video Game Nerd doing a review of this. And, yeah, he didn't enjoy it at all. And I actually thought the review looked okay. So I'm looking forward to giving this one a go. I haven't tried it yet. My NTSC NES is sort of packed away at the moment. But I will pull it out and I'll give it a go. But I'm really happy with it. Over the moon. Only thing I'm really pissed off about is I had to pay fucking custom charges to get this. It initially cost me $20. And it was $12 postage, which I thought was really cheap anyway. But I thought, well, the seller's obviously gone and checked it. That's how much it is to cost. It didn't come in any sort of special packaging. It came in a cardboard box with a bag up here. Just a plastic bag at the top and at the bottom. That was it. So, no special packing whatsoever. So, I'm surprised it got here in as good condition it's in. But, yeah, I had to pay $20, $12 postage and £11.65 custom charges. £8 for handling. What the fuck is handling? What the fuck is that? What, picking up the game, it costs you £8? Bollocks. So, I'm really pissed off with that. So, the seller got an earful, I'll tell you that. But anyway, happy to get it in the collection anyway, so even though it's cost me a bomb, I don't plan on selling it on, so that doesn't really matter. I wanted it anyway. And the next one is a PAL game, and I know Time Team 1982 has got a loose cart of this game. I'm not sure if he's got a box copy of it, actually. I think he might have a box copy. I think he did say he did have a box copy of it. But it is Godzilla, Monster of Monsters. God-awful game, but it's a must for the collection. And I got this one really, really cheap. I got this one for £2.50. And it's £3 postage. Which I thought was a bargain. Because this game can go for more than that on eBay. It seems to have a bit of a cult following. I'll show you the back of the box. That shows you screenshots of the best parts of the game. Because the rest of it is mainly just shit. But there you go. Godzilla. Or Godzilla. Godzilla. Kicks ass. So yeah, shit game, but must for the collection. And the box isn't in bad condition, actually. I'm really, really pleased with that. It's got a couple of scuffs here and there, but I quite like that. It adds a bit of history to the game, so that's cool for me. So yeah, so that was cool. So absolutely awesome to get that in the collection. Right, moving on, because this video is starting to go on a lot longer than I had initially planned. I got a box of games off of eBay. Now, all this cost me £15, and it was £5 postage. No, sorry, I'll tell a lie. It was £15, it was £10 postage. And basically, it's, well, I'll show you anyway. I got a wee case, and inside it's got an Advance SP, which is pretty cool. It's got some makeshift sticker on the front of it, but it's pretty cool. It works fine. Haha. So yeah, so that was cool. Just a job lot of stuff the boy was selling, so I just thought I'd get right in there. He sent me another case for it as well. Just an empty case, so I can hold games and stuff in there, so that's pretty decent. He sent me a game store as well thing. It's like a wee padded bag. When you open that, I don't know what the fuck this is. But there you go. Apparently the SP slots into this. And you can, oh, it's got even got expansion ports on the side for whatever the fuck it is. And at the top there. So yeah, you can plug the SP into that and it does something to it, and I don't know, I've tried it. Can't seem to get it to work. So, but yeah, I'm gonna see. Actually, hold on. No, I can't open that. But yeah, I'm gonna message the seller and find out what that was all about. Actually, because I need to know what that is. But it was in there anyway. It was a bonus. Why not? So yeah, and then I got, there's no charger with the SP unfortunately, but yeah, I think I've got a charger anyway. My girlfriend's got one that had a charger with it, so that was cool. But there's a couple of loose carts, all Game Boy Advance games. Thunderbirds International Rescue, the label's ripped at the front, but I don't give a shit because that was a bonus. And But Ugly Martians, yeah, cool, fucking ace. And he sent me some coloured Game Boy Advance cases. They just hold the games, the loose carts, which is cool because I was needing them. A couple of Game Boy Advance trays for holding the Game Boy Advance games, but they don't work very well. So I will be getting rid of these. But yeah, I think that's what they are anyway, but whatever. I didn't buy it for that. I bought it for the games, really. So first up is Splinter Cell Pandora Tomorrow. Pirate game. Yeah, it's a pirate game, unfortunately. The manual is rubbish. Absolute crap. And the game itself... Well, the game looks fake as well. But it doesn't matter. Tested it, it works fine. So I can't go wrong with that. So that's pretty sweet. I didn't buy it for that game, so I'm not really all that bothered. Star Wars Trilogy, Apprentice of the Force. Now this is the official one, because I got a pirate one a wee while ago. As you can see in the back. The box is a bit beat up, which is a bit of a shame. But it's boxed and complete, and that's pretty awesome. Road to WrestleMania 18, boxed and complete again. Looks pretty sweet. Box is a bit beat up, but, you know, ain't too bad. This is a worse condition box out of the lot, actually. Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl. It's boxed and complete, but as you can see, it's been through the wars. But, like I say, boxed and complete, so I'm happy with that. A game I wanted to play, actually, but then seeing the screenshots in the back, it looked terrible. Daredevil. I actually liked the movie, I'm not going to lie. I quite liked the film when it came out. That's the screenshots in the back. And its box is in really, really good condition, so I'm happy with that. Now, Yu-Gi-Oh! Reshef of Destruction. Boxed and complete, minus the three limited edition game cards. But I really don't care about that. But it's boxed and complete. Aside from that. And CT Special Forces. Now it's boxed and complete as well. And finally, a game that I actually bought the lot for, it is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. And that is in mint condition. I checked with the seller first before I put a bid in to make sure that this was in good condition, and it was. So I'm really happy with that. So that is awesome. And it's boxed with inserts as well. They're not actually. I think there's only two of them that have actually got their inserts in them. You know, the cardboard bit that holds the game. This one has that, which is cool. And I'm really, really happy with it. Absolutely awesome. So, yeah. So it's for £25 all in for that Game Boy job lot. You can't really go wrong with that. But anyway, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Please rate, comment and subscribe, as always. Let me know what you think of the pickups that I got. I think I got some good deals here. And yeah, take it easy. And I shall see you in the next video. Bye for now.